Hi dear students, welcome you all on the behalf of Rahul Anand Biology Tutorials. So as you know that I am Rahul Anand and this is somewhat around my channel whose name is actually the Rahul Anand Biology Tutorials. So now let's begin with the very interesting topics which are often being asked in terms of your NEET, often the AIIMS, often the All India Pre-Medical Examination. So these are literally belonging from which of the chapters of your book. So these are belonging from the human reproduction. So today here we are going to study about one. So today here we are going to study about the oogenesis. So the whole wonderful process what? So the whole wonderful process of the formation of what? Particularly the 28th days of the egg cells or rather the ovum inside the ovary. So it is called as what? So it is called as the oogenesis. Understood? So the whole wonderful process of the formation of the what? In order in term of the 28th days of the egg cells or rather the ovum inside the ovary. So it is called as the oogenesis. Often the overall process of the oogenesis are literally being divided in term of the three different phases. So these are the multiplication phase, then the growth phase, then the maturation phase. So in this case of the multiplication phase, the here mint of the ovary germinal epithelium will be undergoing what? So your ovary germinal epithelium will particularly becoming larger in size, as well as it will be resulting in the formation of the oogonia. Then what? In the particularly formation of the oogonia as well as the EMC. Again in the second step we are having the EMC. So your EMC will be again being divided in order to form what? In order to literally form the rounded mass of cell. So these rounded mass of cell are called as the egg nest. As well as talking about the particular case in terms of the next. So these particularly what? Egg nest again divide and divide in order to form the two types of the particularly cell. So these are what? So these are nothing else but the primary oocytes then the particularly granulosa cells. And the next particular cells in terms of the granulosa cells particularly surround and give the protection towards what? So it particularly surrounds as well as particularly giving protection towards your primary oocytes. Often the overall process is literally being employed under the case of what? So the overall process of these things are literally being enclosed in terms of the ovarian follicles then the graafian follicles. Talking in the second case, so we are having what? So we have dealt now just about the multiplication phase. Then in the second we are having what? So we are having the particularly growth phase. Understood? So in this case what will be happening? So in this case we have the primary oocytes which are literally being present in term of what? In term of the graafian follicles. So it will be becoming what? So primarily these will be becoming larger in size, then again it will be dividing as well as reaching towards what of the stage? As well as it will be reaching towards the maturation division. So it is the particular case of the here in terms of the second phase in terms of the growth of development, which is actually what? Which is actually nothing else but the growth phase. Talking about the third case, we are having the what? The maturation phase. So in the case of the maturation phase, we are having what? So we are having the primary oocytes. So your primary oocytes will be undergoing the meiosis first in order to form what? So here the primary oocytes will be literally undergoing the meiosis first to form the two types of the cell. So these are what? So the two types of the cell in order in term the larger one types of the cell. So these are known as nothing else but what? But the secondary oocytes as well as the primary polar body is the smaller one. Understood? So when this particularly in term we are talking means in term of the third phase of the maturation phase. So in this case the primary oocytes will be undergoing the meiosis first division in order to form the two types of the cell. So the two types of the cell which are literally being formed are nothing else in which the larger one are called as what? So these are called as the secondary oocytes and the smaller one it is called as the primary polar body. Then again we are having what? Then again, we are having the second maturation division. So in the case of the second maturation division, the same process will be repeated, but the particular thing which will be formed, so it will be quite different in nature. So in the case of the second maturation division, understood what second? So in the case of the maturation phase, we are having the first maturation division, then the second maturation division. So in the case of the second maturation division, what will be happening? The particularly meiosis process will be employed, and after undergoing the meiosis particular process, the two types of the cells again will be formed, in which the larger one, these are called as the otites, and the second or either the smaller ones, so these are known as nothing else but the secondary polar body. So this is somewhat the condition when we are talking about the three different types of the growth of the development in term of the phase, where we have understood a bit introduction means what are actually the multiplication phase, often the here mean of the growth phase, then the maturation phase. Now let's elaborate as well as conclude these once again. So what is actually the oogenesis? So the whole wonderful process of the formation of the 28th day of the egg cells or rather the ovum inside the ovary, so it is called as the oogenesis. Often the oogenesis process is literally being divided in term of the three broad categories. So these are particularly the multiplication phase, then the growth phase, often the maturation phase. Talking about the multiplication phase, so in this case the ovary germinal epithelium will particularly becoming larger in size, as well as it will be resulting, and after the division it will be literally resulting in the formation of nothing else but the oogonia as well as the EMC. Talking about your oogonia as well as the EMC, so it will be again undergoing the division in order to form one. So it will be again particularly undergoing division in order to form the rounded mass of cells. So these rounded mass of cells are called as what? So these are known as the egg nest. Understood? So these are what? So these are the egg nest. As well as your egg, again the egg nest will be undergoing the particular division in order to form the two types of the cell, in which the larger one will be known as the primary oocytes, as well as the smaller one, so these are called as the granulosa cell. Understood? So the larger one will be known as what? So the larger one, it will be known as the primary oocytes and the secondary in term of the smaller cells. So these are called as what? So these are called as the germinal cells. So these in terms of the germinal cells do provide an important role in order to surround as well as protect the primary, what? The primary oocytes. So the whole overall structure, these are literally being enclosed under the ovarian follicles as well as the Graafian follicles. In the second, we are having the particularly the growth phase. So in the growth phase, what will be happening? So in this case, the particularly primary oocytes which are under present under one, so the particularly in the case of the growth phase we are having one, so we are having nothing else but the primary oocytes which are being present under the Graafian follicles. So it will be particularly becoming primarily larger in size, that's why, as well as this will be often undergoing one, so it will be often undergoing as well as reaching the maturation division phase. Talking about the next as well as the last phase, so we are having the maturation phase. So in this case, the primary oocytes will be undergoing the meiosis first to form one. So in this case, the primary oocytes will be undergoing the meiosis first to form the two unequal cells, in which the what? In which the particularly larger one cells. So these are called as what? So these are called as the secondary oocytes, as well as the smaller cells, so these are nothing else but the here mint of the first polar body. In the case of the maturation division, we do have the second maturation division. So in the case of the second maturation division, the same process will be employed, will be carried out by the, so in the case of the second maturation phase, the overall process will be again repeated as well as trolled out by the help of the meiosis. And again, the two types of the cell which will be literally being formed. So these are nothing else you can tell what kind of the cell will be literally being formed. So in this case, the two types of the cell which are being formed, so these are the primary otites. Then what? Then particularly, or rather you could say, the larger cells which are being formed, so these are called as what? So these are called as the otites. So these otites literally further develop the ovum or rather the egg cells, as well as the smaller cells. So these will be known as what? So the smaller cells which will be formed, so these are called as nothing else but the secondary polar body. So I thought you have got the concept, means what are actually the process of the oogenesis. So you could often write this. So if you like the work with reference to the education, as well as the lectures, as well as the videos, so you could particularly subscribe, then particularly like, as well as comment below in the text. Thus I will be knowing that what concept actually you are hungry for, or what haven't you understood or either got. So very thank you with the reference to the Rahul Anand biology tutorials. Very thank you.